Last year, I released this video, which was called WordPress Block Themes, Don't Make This Beginner's Mistake, which has now had 65,000 views and 2,000 likes. And it talked about the right way to set up a WordPress block theme, because it's still a bit confusing. Well, the good news is somebody's just released a free WordPress plugin that makes the whole process incredibly simple and only takes a few minutes. Let's dive in. Okay, I'm going to show you the process from a fresh new website. I'm using WordPress.com Studio, which is for free download, which lets you basically build sites locally. So it's really cool. So I'm just going to call my site Block Themes, and I'm just going to go add site. This just gives me a brand new fresh website very, very quickly. This is running on Playground technology, so it's super cool. Right, here's my site. Let's go to WP Admin so we can actually see it. Let's make this bigger so you can see what I'm dealing with. So it's just a completely fresh install of WordPress. Let's go and look at it, visit the site. You can see it's just using the 2025 theme. The blog is the homepage. My menu isn't set, so I've got some issues. But here is how you can set things up incredibly quickly. So just go to plugins and you're gonna click on add new plugin at the top here. Come across here and you're gonna search for Twentig. This is the plugin we're gonna use, which is one of my favorite free plugins for block themes. It does a whole host of other cool stuff, which I will put a link to. I've done a video on some of the cool stuff it does in the description below if you want to check that out. Now just activate it. The magic is about to happen though, and here's the magic. So this is basically gets you onboarded really, really quickly, and the way they do it is through starter sites. So all I want you to do is click on choose a starter site here, and here are the four starter sites that they give you out the box. And you can see we've got business, news blog, photo blog, or personal blog. I'm going to choose a business site, so I'm just going to click on import, and it will say here it will import content and navigation. It will override your templates, template parts, and global stars. But essentially, it's going to set the homepage, set the blog page, set the navigation, and also import some demo content, which you can edit. So it's doing all the kind of complex stuff in terms of block themes right up front. So all you're going to do is click on import and wait a second or so. It won't take long. There we go. Import complete. Let's go and visit the site. So this is the homepage of the website. You can see it set the homepage. Now, obviously, it's demo content, but you can just jump in here and change this content because it's set up as just a page. You can see on the top here, it hasn't put the content in the template, which is one of the things I try and emphasize to customers is don't put your content in the templates, put your content in the pages. And you can see if I click on edit page here, it's actually put the content in the page, because if we go back to the dashboard and then go to settings and reading, you can see it's actually set all our settings, our reading settings for us. It set the home page and set the post page. It's also created the menu for us as well, our navigation, if we go into edit site. If we look along here, it's actually created the menu for us as well. So this is all set and ready for us to go. Let's just click on the right thing so you can see that. There we go. There's our navigation all ready to go. So if we add new pages, we can automatically add them. So it's got us over that hurdle as well. And if we go to our templates, you can see it's actually set the templates up for us. Now, obviously, end users don't have to touch this at all if they don't want to. But I just want to show you what's happened. If I click on the list view here, you can see we've got the header and then we've got the content. So it's bringing in the content of the page. But again, our end users never have to touch this. The other cool thing about this plugin is if you want to switch to another starter site, you can do it. Just come back to Twentig, come here, choose a starter site. So let's say you want a news blog, you can click on import. It's going to warn you. So I can choose whether I want to delete previously imported content. Let's do that. Just have a play. And it's going to do the same thing again. It's going to do the startup and setup again. So as I'm using this, I'm thinking, wouldn't this be great if this was just part of WordPress block themes now, that we had this easy way to onboard clients really, really quickly. You can see you can get started incredibly fast, and it just gets you over those hurdles, setting the homepage, setting the blog page, setting up the header, all that stuff, which is pretty confusing conceptually. So let me know what you think. Do you think something like this would be really great in core WordPress? I personally think it would. Do you use the Twentig plugin? If you don't, go and have a play. It's completely free. I will put a link in the description for you. And I hope you find it useful and it gets you up and running with block themes more quickly than has been possible before. And if you did find it useful, if you can drop a like, that would be fantastic, because it does make a huge, huge, huge difference in terms of how many people actually get to see this video. It really, really does. So thank you if you can hit that like button. And also, every time you do hit that like button, our cats get a little treat. If you want to see more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and you'll be notified every time I release a new one. Thank you so much for watching. Keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.